Well, Gene, officials hope that some advanced forensic testing will provide some desperately needed answers in this disturbing case.
It's a case that has troubled investigators for decades. The bodies of three young girls and a woman found in two 55-gallon drums in the Allenstown woods 15 years apart. The victims were never identified, and this homicide has remained a mystery.
Typically what we do in a homicide investigation is do at least a 24 to 72-hour background on the victim or the victims. Here, we simply can't do that because we don't know who the victims are. So we're really at square one in this case.
But now, with the help of the National Center for Missing and Exploited Children, new forensic testing, including cutting-edge DNA analysis, is being used to help put names with these faces. More importantly, investigators hope they can determine a connection between the victims, which could ultimately lead to their killer or killers.
If we can correctly identify what that relationship is, then perhaps somebody knows of a mother and two children and a stepchild, or a mother and three children, or an aunt and three nieces.
The first barrel found in 1985 contained an adult woman and a child between 5 and 10 years old. The second drum, 100 yards from the first, found in 2000, had two children, one aged 2 to 4, and the second between 1 and 3 years old. State investigators will also be getting some help creating new digital composite images of the victims that they hope will be more accurate than the current ones they're using.
You want very much, like every investigator who's touched this case, I want very much to be able to provide to the family of those children an answer as to what happened to them.
Investigators say they hope to have some answers from the most recent round of testing in about 3 to 5 months. Reporting live in the newsroom, I'm Andy Hirschberger, WMUR News 9.